Hi there, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröger from Dagubi. Today I would like to show you how to draw three flowers, and I'm going to show you how to use the blending modes and how to work with watercolor brushes. So create a new document. 340 mm by 210 mm and color mode RGB. So in this tutorial I will work with my own watercolor brushes. The watercolor brushes are available on my website dagubi.com, and I start with the stamp and washes. So take one of these brushes, for example this. So next you have to choose stroke color. So I'd like to draw with red color, and I use the paintbrush tool, make a double click, and I set slider to this position and click OK. So I use for each blossom a new brush. So my first flower, I'm set the blending mode to normal. And I like to draw the next blossom behind these two blossoms. So go to the toolbar on the left side and we'll see this little button, drawing mode. And I change it to draw behind. And choose another brush. So next, I'd like to modify one of my brushes. So I take this brush. And now I'm going to my brushes panel. These are the brushes library. And these are the brushes inside the document. And I'd like to modify this brush. So make a double click on this brush. And I'm going to change the direction. Okay. So now when I draw with this brush, if you change the direction, so I make again a double click and change the direction. So that's different, and now delete this, and I take a second brush and change again the direction. Change the size a little bit. So I'd like to change the size in very small steps. So hold down the control key and you can click on these small arrows. I'd like to change that brush. So, and next change the color to orange. So, but this time I'd like to draw over all the other blossoms, so change the drawing mode to normal. So, delete this. Try another brush. For example, this. So that's better. So this is my first flower with the blending mode normal. So next I'd like to move some of the blossoms. So I do that with the transform tool, the free transform tool. So hold the control key to select the single blossoms. So use the arrow keys on your keyboard to move. So next I'm going to make a copy from the whole group, from the whole layer. Drag the layer down to this small button, new layers button. So this is my first flower with the normal blending mode, and now I'm going to change the second flower to another blending mode. So select all, and now I'm going to change it to darken. So this is the result if you draw with the darken blending mode. And make again a copy. And the third flower, I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply. So it's important to select the flower not by click on this circle. So choose the selection tool and select flower and change the blending mode to multiply. So these are my favorite three blending modes. This is normal, darken and multiply. And when I draw flowers, I combine all the blending modes. So first I'm going to draw three flowers with the same blending mode. So I start or I continue with normal blending mode. So we need another brush. So I think that brush, and we need green color. And I'd like to draw behind. Go to the left toolbar and choose draw behind. And set stroke white very thin. So next I use my Stampin' Washes brushes. And I try that brush. So this time draw not behind. Delete that and change to draw normal. Set the stroke white to a very short line, and you can change the width profile. So I set the first width profile, so that's fine. So the whole flower with a normal blending mode. So create a new layer and change the blending mode to darken. And I start again to draw the flower. With red color. And now change drawing mode to draw behind. So if you draw with the blending mode, darken or multiply, you can leave it to draw normal. It's not so important to set behind or normal. And I use these two modified brushes. Now with orange color. So now with green color. So if I arrange that line behind, it's not different, so because the blending mode is darken, so if you don't like it, you have to draw a short line. You can change the width profile, and now a short leaf. And create a new layer, and the third flower I'm going to draw with the multiply. And the same red color, so if you like to use the same red color, so select one of these flowers and Illustrator change the color automatically to the same color of the object you selected. So we have green stroke color, and when you select the red blossom, Illustrator change the color to red and selected the same brush inside the brushes panel. So I start with this brush. Set the stroke height to 1 point and change the blending mode to multiply. And orange color. So green color, I'm going to select this green stroke to get the same green color, and now change my brush. So I'd like to scale the flower a little bit. So select the whole flower, And now scale the flower. So, and it's important to check the options for the transform. Open the transform panel. So these are the transform panel. And it's important to enable the scale, strokes and effects. If you don't do that, so we have that. So undo. And now again, enable scale, strokes and effects. So multiply. And change the width profile. So next I'm going to draw with the blending modes. I'm going to combine all blending modes and draw with a little bit more detail. So I start with my first flower. So I'd like to add two blossoms. So I use that brush and I'd like to draw behind and this red color, so the legged blossom to set the same red color. And again the brush. Try again. That's fine. And new blossom. So next I'm going to use some brushes for my free brushes set. So I choose this brush and now I'm going to change blending mode to multiply. Oh, sorry. It's important to change the drawing mode to normal. First, undo. So next, I use this brush. So if you like to make a little bit more color variation. You can change the color to, for example, to yellow and use blending mode multiply. So you can try another color. So I think I take the yellow color. You can change the stroke white. So next I use orange color. And I use my modified brush with very thin stroke white. And change the color to a little bit more brown. So that's fine. And I'm going to change one of this leaf to blending mode darken. So next I take the same green brush and set the stroke white to very thin. So when I like to deselect the selected brush, I hold down the control key and click on your artboard to deselect. And now I need dark green color. But this is too dark. Oh, sorry, select the brush. So that's fine. Don't like the green color, so make it more. That's fine. So, and last, I need a new brush set. And brown color, set the stroke white to 1 point. And set the blending mode to multiply. It's so that's fine. So now my second flower. I use in this flower the blending mode multiply. And now again I use brushes for my free brushes set. And set this time I use not red color, I use a little bit more brown. or dark orange. Oh, sorry. Little bit darker. And now I'm change the color to pink. And again yellow. And use another brush. So this time I change the blending mode from that brush. So if you'd like to find that brush inside the layers panel, so open the layers panel options and click on locate object. So and I change arrange it to bring to front. So first set the blending mode to normal, but I don't like that brush, so I'm going to change it. And scale it a little bit. Sorry. So darken is a little bit better. Yes. And now I'm use again my modified brushes with brown color. And multiply. And a little bit yellow. and I set the leaves to blending mode darken. And I'm going to change the width profile from that leaf . So I use this brush, select this brush, and again deselect, and now change the color a little bit and set this to the blending mode to multiply, and set the stroke white to very thin. So this is my flower with the blending mode darken. And again, first I use brushes from my free brushes set and dark red or brown color and blending mode multiply. And it's important to set the stroke white to 1 point or more. And now change again the color. And last with brown color or dark red. So if you like to add a dark edge, so we can use the modified brushes. So now I use another brush for the leaves. So I open my short strokes brushes and I use one of these brushes. So I'd like to apply one of these brushes to, I'd like to change the brushes. So select one of these brushes of the leaves. And now if you select one of these brushes, Illustrator changes that brush. But if you like to change it with the same width profile, so first undo. So this time hold down the Alt key and click off one of these brushes. So Illustrator apply automatically the same width profile. So this is without the Alt key. Undo, and if you hold down the Alt key, this Illustrator uses the same width profile. So that's better. So next I'm going to move the flowers. So the second flower. And scale it a little bit smaller. So you can change the group behind. So the big flower is my flower with the blending mode normal. And this is my third flower with blending mode multiply. And last, this is a flower with a blending mode. Oh, sorry. This was my flower with multiply, and the second was a blending mode darken. So that's fine, maybe a little bit bigger. So and last I'd like to add some splatters. And I do that in a new layer, create a new layer and going to lock the other layers, and I start with yellow color. So So set the blending mode to darken or multiply. Change the color a little bit more green. So now create a new layer and move this layer behind, drag this down, and we need one of those stamp and washes brushes. And I'd like to add a little bit blue color. Oh, sorry. Change the stroke white to very big. So I'd like to use another brush. And little bit red color. So that's fine. And like to apply some little dots, some splatters. And change the color a little bit darker. And set the stroke white to 1 point. So if you like to change the color, all three sliders together, hold down the control key and move the sliders. So that's fine. And white color. So this time set the blending mode to normal. So that's it, I'm finished with the drawing, and now it's very important. So if you like to clean up your brushes, so I like to delete all unused brushes. So I've tried many brushes, and all the brushes I've tried inside the brushes panel, and I like to delete all unused, so go to the brushes panel. brushes panel options and click on select all unused. So you can see some of the brushes are selected. These two brushes. So next click on that button, delete brushes, and yes. Now we have all brushes we used inside the image in the brushes panel. So if you like to use the same brushes in a new document, you have to store that brushes, and you can do that by open or click on this small button inside the brushes panel and click on save brushes, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click on save brush library and save brushes. These are the default paths to your to save the brushes. You can use another folder, but I recommend you to do that in this default folder location. So now when you create a new document, you can see the brushes panel are empty. These are only the default brushes inside Illustrator when you create a new document. And next you have to go and go to user defined, and you will find flowers 2 brushes. So these are the same brushes we use in this image. So I close it. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.